Willem Einthoven was a Dutch doctor who developed the ECG. The ECG is an excellent invention. It enables us to infer what is happening within the heart at a structural and functional level without us having to request some form of imaging, which can be very expensive and require expertise and advanced equipment. An ECG is cheap and can be easily taken by most healthcare professionals with the correct training. In this video, we will review why on a 12-lead ECG, certain leads are associated with certain cardiac views, and in turn, the vascular territories. Let's start with the general anatomy and the views. If we look externally, note that these regions roughly represent the right atrium, this the right ventricle, this the left atrium, and this the left ventricle. What is the difference between a vascular territory and a cardiac view? If we review the cardiac anatomy, there are the following major vascular territories: the left circumflex artery, the left anterior descending artery, septal branches, and the right coronary artery. And these are each associated with specific cardiac regions or views, which are the lateral, anterior, septal, inferior, and posterior aspect of the heart. So if there's vascular injury of the left circumflex, one will see changes from the lateral aspect of the heart. And on ECG, there are certain leads associated with specific cardiac views. So to identify this injury to the left circumflex artery, we would then look at the ECG leads that look at the lateral perspective. A 12-lead ECG has 12 views. Each one aims to provide a specific vantage point of the heart. In other words, they theoretically provide us with 12 different views or perspectives of the heart. This is a lot like the blind men in the elephant parable. In this parable, the blind men were tasked to inspect and describe an unknown animal with their sense of touch. Each provided their own assessment of what this animal could be best described as. One felt its ears and said it was like a fan. Another felt its side and said it was like a wall. Then another felt its trunk and said it was a snake. Its legs felt like a tree trunk, whilst its tusks felt like a spear. And its tail felt like a rope to a different man. In essence, each provided a completely different description of the animal, which was dictated by their individual perspectives. None was wrong in their assessment, but each assessment was incomplete. In the same way, looking at a single lead on an ECG provides an incomplete picture, and therefore when analyzing an ECG, it's important to look at all the possible perspectives to get a complete and more accurate picture. These leads are lead 1, 2, 3, AVF, AVL, AVR, and V1 to V6. They theoretically provide us with 12 different views or perspectives of the heart. These can be further grouped as lateral, anterior, septal, and inferior leads. Leads 2, 3, and AVF are the inferior leads. Leads 1, AVL, V5, and V6 are the lateral leads. And V1 to 4 are the anterior septal leads. It's important to know this when interpreting an ECG. These groups of leads are known as contiguous leads. And when an abnormality is detected on ECG and involves the contiguous leads, it is likely a vascular injury since it's within the same vascular territory. So what did you learn in this video? You learned that the anterior heart is largely formed by the right ventricle. The inferior aspect is largely formed by the left ventricle. We also reviewed the various vascular territories and how they link to the cardiac views. And then on ECG, we can assess specific views or vascular territories by looking at the contiguous leads. Therefore, abnormalities involving the lateral leads suggest injury involving the left circumflex artery, the anterior septal leads, the left anterior descending artery, and the inferior leads suggest involvement of the right coronary artery. At this point, you may be wondering, why are these leads known as contiguous leads in the first place? That is covered separately as we review Einthoven's triangle and the hexaxial reference system.